Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Well, Mr. Lewandowski, welcome to the Judiciary Committee. You and the President are accused by the majority of a cover-up of foreign collusion, but the Mueller team of partisans, try though they did, couldn't find any evidence of collusion. So since you stand accused of this crime, I'm just kind of curious, how do you cover up a crime that never happened?
It's a great question, Congressman. I don't know the answer.
You've been watching the crux of the majority's case. It's that the President asked you to suggest to the Attorney General that he should say the President is being treated unfairly and had done nothing wrong. Is that essentially the accusation against you?
It seems to be, yes, sir.
Well, I think the record's pretty clear. The President was being treated unfairly, and he had done nothing wrong. Yet it's upon this pretext that the Democrats feel justified to invoke impeachment. The solemn power reserved to the Congress for treason, bribery, and other high crimes and misdemeanors. That's the power to nullify the constitutional election of the President of the United States, a decision made by the American people. Does that sound like an abuse of power in this case to you?
It does.
It certainly does to me, too. For more than 3 years now, our nation has been torn apart by this monstrous lie that the President of the United States was a willing agent of a hostile foreign power. I'd like to ask you, where do you think this whole lie of Russian collusion started?
You know, Congressman, I don't have the facts on it, but I think when Inspector General Horowitz has the privilege of coming here and testifying, he'll testify that this began at the highest levels of the government and was perpetrated through the intelligence community to come up with a narrative of why Hillary Clinton lost the campaign as opposed to the real narrative of why Donald Trump won the campaign.
Well, this actually began before the election. Do you believe the U.S. government, through its justice and intelligence agencies, deliberately interfered with the 2016 presidential election?
I believe there are members of the intelligence community who have been referred for criminal referral for perjury and other crimes, should be held accountable for using their badges and their guns to try and influence the election, spy on American citizens in a clear violation of the Fourth Amendment, and falsifying FISA applications for the explicit purpose of trying to prevent an individual from being elected President of the United States.
If we're serious about protecting the American political process from unwarranted interference, either by foreign governments or by our own government, where should we be looking?
I would recommend Inspector General Horowitz, U.S. Attorney Durham, who's in the middle of an investigation. I would also, if it were me and I were the chairman, or maybe someday in the upper chamber, we'll bring before us James Comey, Clapper, and Brennan, and have them answer the questions under oath that seems to elude them so many times when they sit before these committees.
Well, by the way, we have suggested to the majority that we need to do precisely that, and so far all of those requests have fallen on deaf ears. But here's the picture that seems to be slowly taking shape as more and more information comes to light. We have a phony dossier produced by the Clinton campaign, and we have disinformation channeled to George Papadopoulos through Joseph Mifsud, who it turns out has a long history of involvement with Western intelligence agencies, including the CIA. That was then used to justify a sham investigation. That investigation was then leaked to the press to give credence to this false narrative. Is that what you see taking shape here with the evidence that's slowly coming out?
I think that's exactly right. And you look at the role that Bruce Orr and his wife Nellie Orr played at Fusion GPS, the culpability they have, the fact that they at least notified the FBI of the lack of credibility of Christopher Steele and the information that he was providing. Should give us great pause that such a small group of individuals at the FBI who comprised Crossfire Hurricane had the opportunity to set in motion a plan to try and prevent a person from being elected President of the United States with no evidence whatsoever.
I think the importance of this cannot be overstated. We entrust the most terrifying powers that the government possesses to these agencies, literally the power to ruin lives, to spy on you, to incarcerate you, to launch pre-dawn raids on your home. The abuse of these powers for political purposes would be a direct threat to the most fundamental freedoms that we have as Americans and the most fundamental institutions of our democracy. I should think that that would be of some passing interest to every member of this committee.
Well said, Tom.
Yield back.